entrepreneur, talk show host, and now film producer. Is there anything that Mo Abudu can't do?
Wow, that's a loaded question. I'm sure there are many things I can't do. I find that there are certain gaps that need to be filled. And at that right time, I get a whisper that says, Mo, it's time to do that next thing.
Her next thing, of course, is taking on the film industry, teaming up with Bea Bandelli, a celebrated filmmaker and playwright. And their movie is getting the star treatment in the UK, enjoying its world premiere at this year's London Film Festival.
Describe what's going through your minds right now.
Oh, I'm excited, a bit nervous,
yeah.
Not sure. I mean, excited mainly and happy. It's a great moment for me, yeah. For us.
If you call me one more time,
I'm going to change my number.
I booked an appointment with one of Harley Street's best. I am giving these beauties some TLC. What do you think?
I think the big deal about 50 is that it really is just telling the story of four very ordinary, you know, middle-class women.
50 is the new 25. What a load of rubbish.
And people all over the world should be able to get an insight into who is the African woman of today and some of the challenges that she's dealing with. But it's celebrating the best of filmmaking to come out of Nigeria.
Finally, I'd like to bring on a person without whom the movie wouldn't have happened at all. Our executive producer, Mo.
This is really coming full circle.
I mean,
all of these people, they're here for you.
I know.
This is central London. I mean, it doesn't get any better than this, you know, for a world premiere.
And what are we thinking? More films in the future?
Absolutely. More films, celebrating women, showcasing women, empowering women. I think that's the space I'd like to sort of play in.
When I look at all the different things I've done, from setting up Vic Lawrence, my consulting practice, to the Protea Hotel, Oakwood Park, before Moments with Mo and then Ebony Life and Ebony Life Films, pretty much at that point in time, you are consumed by that project. And that's all you see. You breathe, sleep, dream it. I think I've pretty much gone past, you know, being afraid of taking risks. I mean, I'm afraid,
so no,
but—
No fear.
There's fear, but do it anyway. Because at the end of the day, what have you got to lose? I don't like the word no. Don't tell me it can't happen. It can happen. Maybe you're not the right person to help me make it happen. So let me just move on and find that next person that believes in this dream. And there's always somebody that will.
Someone like Kene, Mkparu, the former boss of Odeon UK, part of the largest cinema chain in Europe. He now runs his own business in Nigeria and is helping to bring 50 to audiences across the West African nation.
Our aim is to roll out 25 cinemas in 6 years, which is kind of madness, but I think we'll do it in 4.5 years. We currently have 9 cinemas across Nigeria.
I see a country where a small 3-screen cinema in Surulere in Lagos turns over in a year far more money than big multiplexes in England.
In late 2014, Kene gave a TEDx talk, opening up about his big push into the Nigerian cinema industry.
And one of the things you said was, consider what you hold in your hands. What do you mean by that?
What's in my hand? I know how to write a cinema business plan. Okay, write it. Okay, I can buy paper. So I wrote it. What else? I know which bank gives money. Okay, take it to the bank. So just do what you can do. And we took it to the bank and they loved it. And the rest is history.
While Kene sees big growth opportunities for the entertainment industry, he does admit there are challenges.
You know, we're in show business industry, but a lot of our industry folks, you know, Nollywood focus, they've always been on the show, far more than the business. You know, so when they engage the government, it's usually from the show perspective, but we need to engage the government from the business perspective far more these days.
And if you get entertained, you buy another ticket.
I would engage any government of the day that comes into power to say that we do need to put more effort into creating what I call the creative economy. Because when you look at the entire value chain, that's at stake within that. There must be more resources that are put into that, because not only can we find a domestic market, we can also find an international market. So we just need to take what it is that we're developing and put it on a global stage so that the world can see that there is such a thing called the African dream, and it becomes a reality. And I'm living proof of that.
And speaking of the African dream, what's the next whisper you're hearing?
I don't know what that next whisper is, but I do believe I love my country, I love my continent, and I think that if God says in my heart that I should play a role in nation building, possibly that could be the next dream.